Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. We are here because we want to prepare for the GRE. We have been solving GRE math problems out of this book here, the official guide to the revised GRE, the second edition. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You're going to need it. Today we'll solve the problem that you see on page number 274. Please turn to it. Make sure the book is in front of you. Otherwise, you will have difficulty following the work. On page number 274, you will find example 4.2.8, which is asking us to compute the standard deviation of these five observations. Let's get going, shall we? Calculating the standard deviation is a five-step process. It's a five-step process. So let's do it. So first, let's list our observations here. X represents the observations. We have 0, 7, 8, 10, and 10. First thing we need to do here, because computing the standard deviation, as we discussed yesterday, the concept behind what is the standard deviation, why do we do what we do there, we learned that computing the standard deviation involves computing the deviations from the mean, So before we can worry about how much does each of the observation deviate from the mean, we need to know the mean. That's the first step. Calculate the mean, which is typically represented as x bar. So let's do that. X bar in this case, in order for us to calculate the mean, we have to first add up the sum figure here. 7 plus 8 is 15. 5, carry 1, we have 35. So here, the mean is very simple. The mean is going to be, x bar in this case is just going to be 35 minus the, divided by the number of observations. We have 5 observations, 1, 2, 3, yeah, 5 observations. It's very simple, the mean is 7. So we just calculate the deviations. How do we represent it? X minus x bar. So 0 minus 7 is going to give us negative 7. This is going to give us 0, positive 1, positive 3, and positive 3. There we go. Those are the deviations from the mean. I hope I did not make a mistake. Now this deviation that we just put on the blackboard, observations minus the mean, the deviations in the mean, it is sometimes, in some textbook, it's written like this, with a small x. So that was the first step. The second step is, we calculate the mean. The next step, step number 2, is to calculate what is sometimes in some textbooks referred to as the calculate the curly axis. Curly axis simply the deviations from the mean. Calculate each of these deviations. Curly axis, you see, this is the observation and this is the deviation from the observation, small x. Deviations from the observations. And some textbooks, as I said, they refer to it as a curly axis. We have done that. These are the curly axis. The next thing we have to do is square our deviations. And yesterday, in the last video, the entire 10 minutes, which I hadn't intend to do, but it turned out that way, we spent the entire 10 minutes in the video talking about why is it that we square the deviations? Why do we have to square the deviations? If you're interested in learning that concept, why is it that we do what we do? Watch yesterday's video 394 and you will learn it. So we have to square the deviations. I don't know why I put it way up there. Square each of the deviations, which is the third step. We have calculated our curly axis. We have calculated our deviations. Calculate the curly axis, which is same as saying calculate the deviations from the mean. Deviations from the mean. We have done that. Step number 3. Calculate the squares of it, which we're going to do right now. Negative 7 squared is 49, 0, 1, 3 squared is 9. Step number 4, add them all up. Take the sum of the curly x squared. So let's do that, shall we? 9, that's 27, 27 plus 1 is 28. 8, carry 2, we get 68. We get 68. Hopefully I have not mucked it up so far. So that was step number four. We have only one last step to do, which is simply to take the average of the, we simply take the average, the mean of the curly axis. Take the mean of the curly x squared. Just think, we have to take the mean of it. We are done. So here, this 68 represents the sum of the curly x squared. And to figure out the standard deviation, we're simply going to take our curly x squared, the sum of the curly x squared, and divide by the number of observations to get the average, to get the mean. The mean squared deviations. In this case, it is going to be 68 divided by 5. And finally, I left out one part here. After we do that, you take the square root of it. That's it, we're done. That's our answer. 68 divided by 5, and we take a square root of that. 68 divided by 5 is going to be how much? Let's do it here. How much is 68 divided by 5? I do not know. We'll find out in a second. 68 divided by 5. Well, let's just multiply top and bottom by 2. Okay. 60 times 2 is 120, and 8 times 2 is 16. 120 plus 16 is going to be 120, 130, 136. So it's 136 over 10, which means it is 13.6. This quantity is 13.6. And at this point, at this stage, it is perfectly okay to reach for the calculator on the screen to figure it out. Obviously, you're not going to do this by hand. But try not to use the calculator that they give you on the screen too often, very often, because it's a very primitive calculator. It will take up too much time. Do as much work as you can do by your hand. Every once in a while, it really calls for it. That's when you use it. For example, here we have no choice but to figure out what is the square root of 13.6. And my guess is that, square root of 16 is 4. This is 13.6, almost more than 13.5. It's going to be around 3.8. It's not going to be 3.9. It's going to be around 3.8. And if you want, we can actually do that very quickly. 3.8, we don't have room anywhere. I wonder what 3.8 is going to give us. 38 times 38, 64, 36, 24 plus 6, 24. 24 plus 6 is 30. 3 4 is 24, 4 carry 2, 3 3 is 9, plus 2 is 11. We get 4, 4, 4, 1. There you go. 14.4, 13.6. I would say this is approximately 3.8. It's approximately 3.8, but like I said, 3.8, 3.7, somewhere there. 3.7 might be even closer. 37 times 37, 49, 4. 21 plus 4 is 25. 3 times 7 is 21. 1, carry 2. 3, 3 is a 9, plus 2 is 11. We get 9, 6, 3, 1. 13.69. Oh, I like that. 13.69. We have 13.6. This is 13.69. In other words, the square root of 13.69 is exactly 3.7. We have 13.6. So it's approximately 3.7, not 3.8. But like I said, it's okay to reach for the calculator and just do it out. That was it. I'll see you tomorrow, okay? Bye now.